Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to expose REST APIs through JAX-RS in AEM. JAX-RS is a specification that provides portable APIs for developing, exposing and accessing web applications designed and implemented in compliance with principles of REST architectural style. JAX-RS focuses on applying Java annotations to plain Java objects. JAX-RS has annotations to bind specific URI patterns and HTTP methods to individual methods of your Java class. It also has annotations which can help you to handle input and output parameters like JSON, text, etc. As JAX-RS is a specification, we need to have its implementation to run REST API code. Some of the popular JAX-RS implementations available today are Jersey, REST EC, Apache CXF, RESTlet. AEM is driven based on REST principles, but there is no direct support for creating RESTful services. Let us see how to enable Jersey connector and expose the REST APIs in AEM. As a first step, we need to install the JAX-RS Jersey connector. That connector can be downloaded from this particular URL. search.maven.org, search the com.eclipse.source.jaxrs. So I already downloaded that. The mandatory modules are Jersey all. You can just download this jar, click on this jar. The next one is this publisher. So download this. Then I downloaded again this module provider JSON to enable the support for JSON for the input and output parameters. You can download this. So still, if you need any other optional module, you can download and install it. But for demo, we are going with these three modules I already downloaded. So as is, next step, what we let us install these modules. System console bundles. Okay, install. Okay, first let me install this Jersey all. Yeah, that's fine, active. Now we can install the next bundle. Okay, let me go with the publisher. Install. Okay. The publisher is installed. Now let me go and install the next module. Provider JSON install. Okay, let me verify that it's installed properly. Okay, JSON provider also installed. So the modules are fine now. The next is step, we need to create a component with the JAX-RS annotations. So this is the one. I already have a project JAX-RS service. In that core bundle, I created a REST services package, and this is the class. So if you go with that, so yeah, I added the required annotations. Also, I have another class product.java. You see here, yeah, this is a kind of plain Pojo class to map the input and output. So if you go here, so you need to add a at component, obviously I am the OSI notation, then at path, I am mapping this class to slash products, so it's a parent URL. Then I have a method get product details, so this is mapped to get method, HTTP method. Then at path, I'm going with the dynamic URL, rejects based, so it will match for the category. After this products, it will match for the category title, then slash p, then code. So it's a kind of product URL. Now code is going to be a 5-digit number. So this is the way it will, the pattern will be matched. Then I'm going to producers. I'm saying text, plain text. So it's going to send back the text data. Now you can get the required input parameters here at context, HTTP server request, then response. And again, I am like, because I am going with this dynamic URL, so I am going and enabling the path parameters, category, then the next parameter is the title, then the last one is the code. So these all parameters will be available for your method. So now I am just going and returning, saying return code equal to whatever the values I am getting it here. So that's the get method. The another method I enabled is the post method. So at post, so again path is create, so product slash create. Now it, this produces application underscore JSON, JSON data, also consumes application JSON. It get the JSON data and return the JSON data. Here I am just putting some dummy data. So I am getting the JSON product object, so converted into product object. So then I am just setting the result back, saying products created and some ID is 1, then returning the same product object as a JSON output. So yeah, so this is one thing. Then the next one, the product POJO, I am just having ID, name, title, category, description, result, some of the input and output data. Add this dependency to the POM file, javax.ws.rs, javax.ws.rs hyphen API 2.0. So let me do that maybe. Okay, my case I already added. So please ensure this dependency is added. So otherwise you will be getting a comparison issues. That's it. So now we need to install this to the server. Bundle I will install. Okay. Clean. Install. Auto. Install. Bundle. Yeah. This will install the bundle to the server. Okay, the deployment is completed. Now let's go and verify the bundle. The bundle is active now. Yeah, now the services are ready. What we will do is let us go and access the service. So this is going to be the URL for the get service. So always services will be appended, pre-appended, then products. And obviously, like, you need a category, so I am putting category as test, then what is the title, I am putting as a sample title, then P, then the product ID. So when you access this URL, the request will be matched by that particular REST component. So if you go here, yeah, this particular component, and it will respond back with this data. So code, whatever we send it, it is printed. Now the next service is the post service. So for that URL is going to be services slash products slash create, but we need to pass some input data. So let me test this with maybe some REST client. I will go to Chrome, I will plug in for that. This ARC, that is the plugin. Yeah, so same thing, services products create, so application slash JSON, then in the body I'm just sending something like name, test, title, test, category and description. So I'm just sending this. If you see the response, it will just, the data will come back, ID, whatever we like modified the data, result, product created, ID, the remaining data is same. Yeah, so this post method we defined, so it's accepting the JSON data and returning back the JSON data. Okay, so also like different, we just mapped this get and post. So like this, you can map other methods also, put, delete, yeah, other methods. Then one more thing you can do is even we can map different inputs and outputs. So based on your requirement. That's all for today. Thanks for watching the video. See you in the next video.